Hello everyone. So today we are going to start the second part of the unit 4, which is about the gear generation and gear forming processes. So as we all know that gears are machinery components which are used to transmit motion and power between rotating elements. Okay, that element could be a shaft. There are several of shape processing operations which can be used to manufacture or fabricate the gears. These methods include investment casting, die casting, plastic injection molding, powder metallurgy, forging and other bulk deformation operations, for example gear rollings. The principal machining operations which are largely used to fabricate the gears or to cut the gear teeth are form milling, gear hopping, gear shaping and gear broaching processes. Form milling and gear broaching processes are considered to be the gear forming processes, and on the other hand the other two, the gear shaping and the gear hopping processes, are considered to be the gear generation processes. So this unit consists of discussing these two processes, which are gear generation and gear forming. So now for the definition, the gear teeth are produced by machining based on gear forming processes and gear generation processes. Gear forming processes are those where the profile of the teeth are obtained as the replica of the form of the cutting tool. For example, as I have discussed, the form milling and the broaching processes. On the other hand, the gear generation processes are those where the complicated tooth profile are provided by much simpler form cutting tool through rolling types, tool and work motions. For example, gear chopping, shaping processes and gear hopping processes. So let us start with the gear generation process. First gear generation process is the Sutherland method using rag type cutter. In this type of method, a rag type cutter is used which has a teeth on it, and this is the workpiece blank which is to be cutted in the form of a gear. So in this method, a HSS material rag type cutter is used to generate the teeth on the blank surface. The HSS cutter having rack and clearance angles reciprocates to accomplish the machining action with rolling type. Okay, so in this rack reciprocates to complete the or to cutting the teeth on the gear blank. This method needs though automatic few indexing operations as well. So this type of gear cutting method is used in moderate size straight and helical tooth external spur gears with high accuracy and finish, and cutting the teeth of double helical or herringbone gears with a center recess groove is also possible with the help of this method. The cutting the teeth of straight or helical fruit clusters can be cutted by this method. The next method which is to be discussed is the gear shaping process. In gear shaping, a circular cutter is used to cut the teeth on the gear blank. The circular cutter and the blank both rotates as a pair of spur gears in addition to the reciprocation of the cutter. This method can be used to cut external as well as the internal gears. So here in this method, this is the cutter which has a sharp teeth on its periphery, and this is the gear blank. So when this sharp cutter and the gear blank meshes with each other, and this sharp cutter reciprocates with greater velocities, with high velocities, so during the reciprocating motion, these tooth profiles are being cutted on the gear surface as well. The same procedure can be adopted to generate the internal teeth, where This is the internal blank and this is the cutter. This cutter reciprocates and cuts the teeth on the gear blank, and this gear blank keeps on rotating at very slow speed so that the whole of the periphery can be cutted in the form of gear teeth. Next operation. This gear shaping method is characterized by automatic indexing and ability of a single cutter to cover the entire range of number of teeth for a given combination of module and pressure angle, and hence provides high productivity and economy. The gear type cutter is made up of generally HSS and possesses proper rake and clearance angle. The additional advantages of gear shaping over rack type cutting are, these are separate, there are separate indexing is not required at all. Straight or helical teeth of both external and internal spur gears can be produced with high accuracy and finish, and productivity is also very high. Next operation is the gear hobbing, where a hob is used to cut the gear teeth on the blank. In this, the HSS or carbide cutter having teeth like gear milling cutter, this is the gear hob, and the gear blank apparently interact like a pair of worm and worm wheel. So this is the blank and this is the gear hob. They resembles like a worm and worm wheel. The hob, the cutter looks and behaves like a single or multiple start worm. So having lesser number, only three or of tool work motions, hobbing machines are much more rigid, strong and productive than gear shaping machine. But the hobbing provides lesser accuracy and finish and is used only for cutting straight or helical teeth single of external spur gear and worm. Okay. There are some advantages of gear hobbing as well, which includes the method is versatile and can generate spur, helical, worm and worm wheels. Since gear hobbing is a continuous process, the hobs keeps on rotating. It is rapid, economical and highly productive. The method produces accurate gears and is suitable for medium and large batch production. The cutter is universal because it can cut all gears of same module irrespective of number of teeth on the gear. The disadvantages of gear hobbing includes, gear hobbing cannot generate internal gears, that is the big problem, and the setup requires enough space for the components of the gear hobbing machine. The various applications of the gear hobbing are, the gears produced by gear hobbing are used in automobiles, machine tools, various instruments, clocks and other equipments. So that's all for today. Thanks.